We were working with Dr. Tim Amukele at Johns Hopkins Medicine, who was interested in trying to improve healthcare in rural Africa. One of the things that we sort of take for granted in our healthcare here is you can go to a doctor and they draw your blood, do testing on your blood sample, then you go see the doctor, he tells you how you're doing. Now, in rural Africa, they have the clinics, they have the labs to do the testing, but what they don't have is very good roads. In fact, the roads are extremely rough, and the process for delivering the sample to the lab is they'll put them in the back of a motorcycle, the back of a truck, it rides down this bumpy road, and what happens is the continual bumping of driving down that road will damage the blood samples. So Dr. Amukele said, well, what if I put this in a drone? He would load samples in there to test where he'd fly them, and even with a fairly rough takeoff and a fairly rough landing, he showed that that didn't damage the blood sample. It has to be the continuous bumping, not an instantaneous one in a flight. So Dr. Amukele met some folks who were aware of the swarming autonomy work that we do. We met with him and said, hey, yeah, we can take your idea and we'll turn that into a system. So working together here with some other engineers, we did flight testing where we took different vehicles out into the field. We're using fixed-wing aircraft here specifically to maximize the endurance because of the distances between these sites. And we also want to maximize the payload they can carry so that we've got the best possible efficiency for these travels. We also did some simulation testing where we could show that we could do a flight controlled landing in a narrow space. That's particularly important in some of these rural clinics where you might have kids playing soccer right next to the clinic. You need this plane to land in a fairly tight spot on a consistent basis. And by the way, all of this has to be completely autonomous, and that's why, you know, we worked on this from a perspective of the normal autonomy work we do here. And all the people at the clinic have to do is come out, put their samples in, swap batteries on the plane, and then throw the plane back into the air, and it knows where to go. It'll fly back to the lab and deliver the samples. So we did the flight testing, simulation of the landing, and then a large simulation where we showed logistically how many planes you would need, what would happen to all the samples over time. And we'd say they'd start building up there, planes would come pick them up and automatically take them back to the lab, and we could tell exactly how old the samples will get, how many planes you would need, so we can make an estimate of how much it would cost to deliver this improved healthcare to a region.